I want to talk about 2022. Earlier on, you already made up your mind, right? You said you're not going to be a part of it. You have no intention to run, even if you have the 22 million vote that's backing you up. Why did you decide earlier on that you're not going to throw your hat into the ring?
No, let me make this clear. The question at the time was, I was being included by some bayan, which I was grateful for the trust. But at that time, I mean, at this time, really the focus is trying to figure out how we can get out of this rut. And, you know, they were trying to figure out who the best candidates are for president. I said, I've done that. I'm not interested to run as president. And I feel that at this point, it's really important. And I think it's good to have as much open discussions as those who are truly interested to run. So that people can make an informed decision. I think it's important right now that the public evaluate how their public servants are serving them or not serving them. And that should really be the focus of the campaign, educating our voters. And I was actually taken aback that I was being considered by some buy-in for that position when I've been quite clear about my position.
So you're going to stay, you're going to continue on with your legislative work. You know, your colleagues, there's a lot of things happening there at the Senate. You have the tandem shaping up between Senator Panfilo Lacson, Senate President Vicente Soto III, Senator Manny Pacquiao has his own issues. Senator Bongo, also part of a Go-Duterte tandem. I'm not going to focus on that. But what is clear now is the kind of legislative work that is expected of you guys if we were to talk about the recovery of this country. What are you looking for in a colleague once election is over and, you know, you got your new set of colleagues there at the Senate, you've got your work cut out for you. What are you looking for in a team member there at the Senate post the 2022 national election, Senator?
It will be the same, and probably our work will probably be more difficult because of all the recovery efforts that we need to do. So, you know, we are in a democratic system. People are free to choose who they want. But it's important to have a legislator who's dedicated, who really has his work in his or her work in the Senate as the number one priority that they have. It's important that their intentions are really to help and to help alleviate the situation of our countrymen. That would be ideal for them to be competent. Now, ako naman kasi, hindi naman pwedeng mangmata at sabihin, ito lamang ang mga pwede sa Senado, yung mga nakapagtapos o yung mga abogado. Kahit naman simpleng, ordinaryong mamamayan, ang importante, nakatutok sa trabaho at nakikipag-usap sa kanyang mga kababayan para malaman kung anong kailangan. At kung ano man yung kailangan na yun, yun ang ipaglaban sa Senado. Diba? Kahit naman hindi ka engineero, hindi ka abogado, pwede pa naman gawin yan.
All right. We're going to have to leave it at that. I'm sure we're going to talk about a lot of things later on in the year. But first, I just want to go back to what you said a while ago. You said at that time, that was the question. Are you still considering it though? Because that seemed to be open-ended for you running for the presidency.
You know what? This is what's important right now. I feel that my focus will be to have a relevant part in 2022. And that would be perhaps even campaigning or going all out for a cause, which I feel will be beneficial for our country. What cause will that be? It will be a cause where I feel that our country has to unite under one particular goal, which is everybody should have an equal opportunity to progress. There should be a definite respect for the rule of law. There should also be a focus on rebuilding our economy. These are causes and goals that I would like to have moving forward in 2022 in any capacity. So, however, I'll be able to advance that, to take an active role to support anyone, I think that is I think we should all do that.
As a senator? Or
as a senator, as a private individual, just like you, as a media personality, to actually ferret out the truth and report it to our countrymen.
And not necessarily as a candidate?
Not necessarily as a candidate. You can do a lot, even if you're not a candidate.
Senator Grace Poe, we appreciate you coming to the show. Thanks a lot. You continue to keep safe and you take care.
You as well. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thanks.